When an atom absorbs energy, it could be electrical energy, thermal energy, or electromagnetic radiation, it tends to re-emit that energy as a photon. This is the principle behind neon signs. If you pass electricity through a gas, the gaseous atoms give off light. Different atoms emit different wavelengths of light. For example, if you pass the light from a hydrogen lamp through a slit and a prism, the light will be divided into its component wavelengths. The result is called an atomic spectrum. Hydrogen spectrum is composed of four distinct wavelengths in the visible spectrum. If you perform this experiment with helium, however, you would get a different spectrum with six distinct wavelengths in the visible spectrum. Each atom has its own unique spectrum. If you perform this experiment with white light, you would see a continuous spectrum. The Bohr model was developed to explain these results. In the Bohr model, the energy of an electron is quantized, which means an electron in an atom can have only particular discrete values of energy. We label these values of energy as energy levels. N equals 1, N equals 2, N equals 3, and so forth. Typically, an electron is in its ground state, which means the lowest energy level that is available. But when an electron absorbs energy, it's said to be excited, and it jumps to a higher energy level. This higher energy level is less stable, because we've separated opposite charges. The nucleus is positive, and the electron is negative, so energy is required to separate them. The electron will spontaneously drop back down to a lower energy level, as it is attracted to the positive nucleus. When it drops from a higher to a lower energy level, it emits a photon with an energy equal to the difference in energy between the two energy levels. Each of the distinct wavelengths present in the atomic spectrum for an atom correspond to transitions between two energy levels in the atom. In hydrogen, for example, when an electron drops from the N equals 3 to the N equals 2 energy level, it emits a photon with a wavelength of 657 nanometers, which corresponds to red light. Since each element has a unique atomic spectrum, we can use a flame to excite electrons in a metal and observe the color of light that is emitted in order to identify the metal. This is called a flame test for a metal. The creators of fireworks apply the concept of atomic spectra when they use shavings of different metals to achieve different colored lights.